Now that we've completed our array using icons, we're going to start creating a bar graph. So most of the graphs on this larger infographic are bar type graphs, and we're going to use the data that we received in our Word document, and we're going to use the graph tool in Illustrator to create the proportions of our graph. But we're not really going to get heavily into using the graphing tools. We're just using them to establish the proportions of our bars in relation to each other. But we're going to be stylizing them so much that we're not going to need to, we're not going to use the bar graph to do that. We can take a look at our data that we're going to use. The first graph that we're going to create is the, it's actually two graphs because they're comparing the 10 most popular of each dog breeds versus cat breeds. So there's one graph for each, and we're going to create two separate graphs. So we're going to get the numbers and information from our Word document, and then we're going to start plugging those in. So going back into Illustrator, we're going to be placing our first bar graph down in this area. Let's create our first bar graph. I'm going to select the column graph tool and then click somewhere in my document. And I'm going to leave this at 300 pixels. Yours will probably be different, but I was experimenting here, so 300 is fine. And we're going to plug in our percentages from our data sheet. So what I'm doing is I'm just typing in the number and then I'm hitting the down arrow to enter it. So 33 is the first one, 20 is the second, 9, 8, then 8 again, 6, 4, 2, 2, and 2. And click the apply button. And we should have 10 bars here. So I just wanted to make sure that I didn't miss anything. And we're not going to be using the column graph tool to edit this anymore. So I want to create editable objects out of this graph, and right now they can only be edited using the column graph tool. So in order to do that, I'm going to hold Shift, Command, and G, and I'm going to say yes. So this is unlinking it from the data in the column graph tool. And I just want the bars. I don't want any of this stuff here, so I'm just going to delete that. And I'm going to rotate my graph 90 degrees, so I'm holding Shift to lock it to 45 degree angles. The next thing I want to do is ungroup these bars so that I can edit them individually. So I'm going to go to Object and choose Ungroup. And now I can select these individually. And then I'm going to select all of them. And I want these to be a specific width. So I want my 33% bar, which is the longest one, to be 232 pixels wide. And the reason it's going to be 232 pixels wide is because I've already figured out previously how this whole graph is going to fit in this space. So it's not just a number I'm pulling out of my head. It's something that I figured out ahead of time, and if you're creating a bar graph from scratch, that's something that you're going to have to do. We want the width of our graph to be 232 pixels wide. I'm going to select all, and I'm going to bring out the transform window because we're going to be using this more than once. And I want the width to be at 232. And I want the height of each of my bars to be 20 pixels. So I need to do this individually. So I just need to select each one and make it 20 pixels. And they're pretty close right now. Okay, and then we want our entire graph to be 286 pixels high. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to create a rectangle object that is 286 pixels. And let me make sure that none of these objects has a stroke, but because that will affect the thickness. And I'm going to zoom in a bit. I'm going to align, and we're pretty close right now. I'm going to align this with the top and the bottom of our graph. And then I'm going to take this last bar and I'm going to align it with the bottom of this box. So this box that I have, or this rectangle, is just being used as a reference point. It's the same depth that I want this graph to be. I'm going to click and drag over all of my bars, and I'm going to click again on this bottom bar to make that the key object and choose vertical distribute from top. And that makes sure that all of my bars are evenly spaced. All right, I'm going to move this object off to the side. Let's go ahead and make our graph for our dogs. So again, I'm going to enter the numbers that I find in my data sheet for the dogs. Make sure that I have all 10 bars. I'm going to hold Shift Command G to make these editable objects. I'm going to pull my bars away from the rest of the graph and then just delete those objects that I don't need. I'm going to select Object, Ungroup, and then right click and ungroup again. And now I can select all of these bars individually. This one I'm going to also rotate. So I want to rotate that 90 degrees, but I want it to go in the opposite direction. So I'm going to choose the reflect tool. And then we're going to make kind of a mirror image of that. This largest bar on the dogs is only 17%, while the largest bar on the cats is 33%. We want these to stay proportional. So the width of the 17% bar for the dogs is 121 pixels. So I'm going to change this to 121. I want to make sure that all of my bars are selected so that I change them all proportionally. And then, again, we want this to be 286 pixels high, this entire group. But we need to change the width. So we need to change the width of each of these bars individually. We need them to be 20 each. So we just need to go through and select those individually and then change the height to 20. All right, so now that we have this graph, each bar sized and proportioned correctly, let's get rid of the stroke. And we can align this with the cat one. And what I'm going to do is take the bottom one and align that with the bottom cat one. Select all again. Double click on the bottom bar to make it the key. And then choose vertical distribute bottom. All right, so now what we can do is group these together so we don't accidentally move them. We can make the cat bars pink fill, so we don't want a stroke on these. Let's make sure we have the fill swatch active, choose pink, and then same for the dogs. We can choose purple. We want the base of our bars on this graph to align with our array right above it. So I'm going to create a couple of guidelines, and I'm aligning with the edge of these icons above here. And I just want to move my holding the shift key so it doesn't get out of alignment vertically. I want to align my bars with these. And this one just happened to be aligned already.